I'm on Schlossberg Via Ferrata. It is a level E, that is extreme. I've been here last year and I know since then that this Via Ferrata is a constant overhang, constantly. If you want to test your limits, well, this is the right place to come and do it. Look what happens here to my situation. I usually use this Ypsilon from Climbing Technology as my main resting system. Today, because I was aware of the complexity, of the difficulty of this Via Ferrata, I took a quick draw with me as well. Why? Because as you can see, the quick draw keeps me closer to the safety steel cable compared to this shorter lanyard of a Ypsilon from Climbing Technology. This quick draw here is one of the resting systems used by some Via Ferrata climbers. Nothing wrong with it. It does a perfect job. As you can see, it keeps you close to the wall. It is ideal if you are on a ledge and you hold on your feet, but to make sure you are not going too much on your back, a short one like this, or even a carabiner between the belay loop and the safety steel cable, will improve the resting situation by a lot. If you put the carabiner straight here to the loop of the shock absorber, you are in the same place as with a quick draw. They say if you put the carabiner, I will simulate just for you to see the example. Let's see. To the loop of the shock absorber, I've connected a carabiner. It's not a Via Ferrata rated carabiner, but will serve as well to give you the example of a resting system. Let me start disconnecting here some of them, because otherwise there are too many and you might get confused. Now, the one under tension is this carabiner here, sitting on the loop of a shock absorber. I don't recommend this, just because by doing this, you stress the Via Ferrata set. And me personally, I don't like the idea of doing that. One argument for doing this is, yes, but if you fall, the shock absorber will absorb the fall, the breaking force of that fall. Wait a moment, how should you fall? You are not supposed to use this on a vertical, only on horizontals in specific conditions. And that condition is, for example, here, the fall, if I fall, is static because there is no slack. So I can have it at my belly line, but the rule on horizontals is when you clip the resting system, you should be as below the cable possible. Now, if let's suppose I'm disconnecting this, because this is not my resting system. Let me take it away. This is my resting system, but even here, you've seen me, I was using the quick draw. I'm only using here in this situation this shorter lanyard of a Ypsilon as redundancy, but in reality, I clipped myself using the quick draw. I've clipped myself using the quick draw. Why? Because in case I lose control, being so high above the horizontal, the distance is short, is extremely short. This distance is way longer. It is still not getting me into trouble. What will get me into trouble will be the longer lanyard of the resting system. But why? You see how much slack I have here. This slack, if I fall, generates a falling force. This is wrong here. It's completely wrong. Me clipping myself being so above, it is not right, but puts me in the best possible situation, because the slack here, if I'm practically curving, nothing more. I'm curving and that's it if I lose control. There is no slack. There is no generated force, no dynamic force at all. You don't have it. Here is no force. But here with this slack, it is a lot of force, like a lot of it. This is wrong on the horizontal. You have to be in this situation, with this one, you have to be way below the cable, way below, at neckline practically. So let me clip myself as I was before, because you see, there was no point. Let me bring you closer to me, or me closer to you. Given my circumstances here, there was no reason for me to use the longer lanyard, but the shorter one. But even the shorter of the Ypsilon is not enough in this situation. It is why I clipped the quick draw. And why did I do this? Because I needed to rest. It's my first break on this Via Ferrata so far. Oh, it was so hard. And what I did today is the cardinal sin practically. I used the resting system, this shorter lanyard of a Ypsilon from Climbing Technology. I've used it on the diagonal, not on the vertical, on the diagonal. Why? Because I was applying vectorial force on the cable, on practically on this carabiner, and I decreased the chances of it sliding. I increased the chances of it staying steady there on the point. At the same time, to my left, I always had the Ferrata block, and I was putting the Ferrata block under tension and practically creating a V vector force. Some of the force applied was through the Via Ferrata block on the left side, and the other one was to the other direction. And in this way, I was able to stay in control.